Hey guys, it's Joyfield Gamer here, and I saw that a lot of you liked the first part of What If Asta Was the Reincarnation of Link. So here's part two. Just to let you know, if you're watching this for the first time, please go and watch the first part so you can get catched up. And so let's just start. So where we left off was where Jacob, which is one of the elves that I made up, if you didn't know, he revealed his biggest secret was that he's actually an elf, which he heard from a few like through these years. He heard stories that like these mythical creatures, elves, Zora, no, dwarfs, even more used to exist back then, like 100 or so years ago. So he tells his secret to his wife, Lucidia, and she accepted him for who he is because she saw how caring and how honest he is to other people. He's someone who's kind. It's because she actually started falling for him because of her through his actions of what he did around the house, what he did in the village. And also, I forgot to tell you, he's actually hiding his ears through a bandana that he's tucked his pointy ears in inside the bandana so people won't see it. So you're gonna skip a bit for like a few weeks ahead because it's just gonna be something that I need your guys' help with. And it's an idea for what magic Asta and Zelda will have. So pretty much, we're gonna first be in the point of view of Elizabeth, who is, if you don't know, the one that actually was carrying Zelda and also is now the guardian of Zelda. But she's also someone that helps around the church. So pretty much, we see that after Elizabeth was somewhat fully healed, like she's still a bit injured, but not that bad anymore. She sees Zelda, and then she starts taking care of her for a few months right now. She was a bit frustrated because she didn't have the patience to take care of a child, but she just decided to take care of, she is someone that decided to take care of, and also the father of the church from canon, and also with she decided to help the father like around the church, help take care of the children and stuff like that. And she actually almost forgot that she actually remembered something that she has to give to the Duke. So she decided to tell the Duke, like talk to the Duke in private, while the children were like the two toddlers of Yuno and Zelda were sleeping. She called the father, which of the church, to if he can talk to her, if she can talk to him in private, and he said yes. Is there anything wrong? Any questions? He said, and she said no, but. She takes out an envelope that she had in one of her little pockets, let's say. She gives it to him, and he asks, "What is this?" There's two envelopes, and she just says, with like a sigh, saying, "There's two envelopes. One is for the girl Zelda, and one is for the person that's taking care of her. I already know some th stuff about Zelda, but I think you should read this so we can trust each other and know what to do." The father was confused and he said, "May I read it with respect?" And she says, "But while you're helping me taking care of Zelda and the other child, you know." So, and the father says, "Okay," and he reads it and it explains, saying, "Hello, who may ever take care is taking care of my daughter. Her name is Zelda, and if you see a friend of a woman or a guy, these two people or one person with her, they are my trusted friends. They are someone that actually used to be knights at like as their past jobs, but now recently retired because of all the stress and everything they went through and the wars that they went through." And Then there's a, if something bad happened, anything when that we were under attack, please take care of my daughter and know that we did not abandon her. We did this for her safety. We wanted, me and my wife wanted to take care of her. And I know this may be strange or may freak you out to whoever you are, but my daughter is also half elf. By the time the father got to that part, he was in complete shock and also like wanted to like just looked up at her and wanted to ask a question, but she said, "Just keep reading." If you think this is shocking, then she's also half human, just to let you know. And the two people that I sent her with are also elves. And then he just, when he gets to this part, he just kind of, he's complete shock. And he says, "You are what?" She says, "Yes, I am an elf, but you have to keep reading." Reading. So, and sorry for the sneeze. Pretty much. He keeps reading it and sees that there was a catastrophe, that something might have happened to them, they might have died or whatever. They just want to see, make sure that their daughter is safe. And if by the time she turns 15, the envelope that Elizabeth holds, or pretty much Jacob, whichever one is the one that's holding the envelope, which is Elizabeth, I want you to give her an envelope when she turns 15 and when she first gets her grimoire. I want her to know of what we did for her and what we sacrificed for her. I hope she lives a normal life as a regular child should, not to worry about her past. So I please recommend you not to tell who we are until she is at the age of getting her grimoire." After the father finished reading it, he kind of is, he has a face, he just sighs and says, "So, you and the girl are elves." Which Elizabeth states, "Well, I'm fully elf, but the girl is half elf, and her mother is a human." Which the Pope states, "Does that mean she gets two magical powers? Does she get just one?" In which the Elizabeth says, "We don't know because she is the first hybrid of human and elf or any kind of hybrid we know." Which the father was actually interested, saying, "So the first hybrid you know of? But don't worry, I will keep this a secret until she is ready for to know the truth." Which Elizabeth thanks him and says, "So how can," she just takes off the hood and says, "How can I hide these?" Pointing at pretty much pointing at both of her long ears, which are extremely noticeable, and he says, "You should wear something like a nun. You should maybe practice as a nun so you can hide those your ears and maybe and you can also take care of Zelda at the same time." Which Elizabeth was thankful and also accepted. So pretty much she was like someone that's the caretaker for that church where asta would have been. But then we switch back over to where Jacob is. Also, just to let you know, Jacob is was sent back a bit more like earlier of a time, like sent back in time a bit more than Elizabeth would be in. And Zelda, but just giving you that information for so you cannot be confused. So then, we go over to Jacob's point of view, saying that he's like enjoying like his family, his son, just seeing his son. So let me give you a, he looks like this, pretty much. He looks like Link, but with the he has gray on the tips of his hair, like on the sides of his hair. And stuff like that, and he has blue eyes like Link. So pretty much, he was. People just came in like ran like When he had to take care of his son, he sometimes had to go grocery, like go for the groceries and stuff. And some people would actually just comment on his son, just like how handsome he is, how adorable and stuff like that. And he thought, oh, it's just compliments. What else can happen? But then a few months later, like when he's able to walk on his own, some of the girls in that, let's say he's close to a village, actually start coming up to Izuku and Asta. I don't know why I said Izuku. What is wrong with me? But Asta, and then they started it's because the girls kept on like blushing at him, saying and how how handsome he is in such a young age. Like all the young girls his age, pretty much. They started having a crush on him, saying he's the handsome kid in the village in a way. But that's not important. Just giving you just giggles and stuff, like how funny it is, because in the games it's like a lot of girls have a crush on Link in some of the games, and it's cool, funny, and for me. So pretty much, let's say they went to a picnic, and Asta was excited because his mom never gets to, like, barely gets to leave the house because of her magic. So pretty much they go to a picnic, which where there's a hill, and it's a really nice view of the village and also maybe the skeleton from pretty far away, like a good amount away, far away. Then Asta just says, I'm gonna go to the woods and just play around to see what's there for an adventure. He's like someone who's adventurous, he's goofy, he smiles and stuff like that. And then, but Jacob says, be careful, don't go too far. And Asta just says, I won't, don't worry. And Jacob says, sometimes I worry about him. Lucidia just leans on his shoulder saying, well, he's adventurous, and it's normal to be adventurous. And Jacob just says, yeah, but who did he get it from? And Lucidia probably says, well, from me, of course. Which they just enjoy having a meal, like food, and just talking about stuff like how they've been, how they're doing, stuff like that. Then they just hear a bit of a scream coming from Asta, and Jacob just stands up and gets ready to get his sword. But before that, let's go a few minutes before that happened. So we go to Asta's point of view. He's going to the village. He's just playing around, doing random stuff. He's like climbing trees, trying to get an apple, and then he hears a voice saying, hello? Which actually kind of creeped out Asta, because, of course, if you hear a voice in the forest, you don't know who it is. It may be a ghost or someone, who knows. So he kind of gets creeped out and questions, who are you? My dad is powerful, so I don't think you should get near me. And pretty much, he just sees a blue light, and then he was like ready to since his curiosity, he was ready to go towards it, but then the shadow, you know, like how you see shadows and sometimes you see them, like for example as a ghost or something like that, it looked like it was something made out of rock or like a really creepy face for kids, and he just screamed. And that's when Jacob came in and says, what happened, are you okay, Asta? And Libe was like comforting him, saying, it's okay, it's okay, like, just comforting him, like, trying to calm him down. Jacob sees the shadow and goes towards it and, like, points a sword at it. And then he sees just a small circle, cylinderish ball of light with wings. And he says, and he just thinks, saying, what is this? He tries to grab it, and then she says, can you, like, just flies away saying, like, from not getting grabbed, saying, can you please not do that? That is very rude. Which Jacob says, who are you? And she just says, I am Nobby, and I am a fairy. In which Jacob was confused of saying, fairies are just legend, like myths. They don't exist. And then Lucidia says, what's over there? Is everything okay? Which Jacob just sheathes his sword and says, yes, everything is fine. It's false alarm. It's just a... he didn't know how to say it, but he just said it's a fairy. Which both Asta and Lucidia was confused, saying, a fairy? Which Asta was still kind of scared and hid behind, like, just held his mother's hand, Lucidia, and they both go walking to where Jacob was. Then they both see a ball of small light flying around, and then Asta says, who are you? And she says, nice to meet you. I am Nobby. I am a fairy. With Asta just hearing, a fairy? So they are real? And with Nobby just stating, yes, we are. And with Lucidia saying, sorry to interrupt, but what are you doing here? Are you lost? Did you lose some of your friends? Or what happened? Which Nobby stating, I actually came here because I actually felt a presence that felt nostalgic for me. It was near, but then she actually gets near Asta and she says, this, him, I actually, for some reason, when I just get near him, it feels nostalgic. Like I met this kid, this person for some reason, this child for some reason. With Jacob saying, what do you mean? You never met him. Some of you already know that this is the reincarnation of Link. So yeah, it's in the title if you don't know. But Nobby states, I don't know. It's just, I just feel nostalgic when I get near him. That's all. Now, just as like a friend or like, just mostly like a friend, like a long lost friend. So pretty much, she says, is it okay if I can stay with you, you people for sure? If you don't mind me asking? And they said, yeah. Asta said, yes, that would be so amazing to like, be friends with a fairy since he's a kid. And then she says, oh, if you don't mind me asking, what is your names? And with Lucidia says, oh, how rude of us. We forgot to introduce ourselves. I am Lucidia, and this is my husband. This is my husband, Jacob, and this is our child, Asta. With Nobby just getting close to him and saying, you kind of remind me of someone. When he was your age. And he said, and Asta just says, who is it? And Nobby saying, his name was Link when I first met him. And they said, that's an odd name, but it's nice nonetheless. She says, yeah, it was odd, but to be honest, he was an amazing child. He is reminding about him. Like, mostly like those eyes, really. But neither way, and then they just hear a bit of a rustle. Both of them, all four of them saying, pretty much all of them saying, what was that? Then they just see something with grayish hair. And they just go, Jacob, being the one with the sword, goes close to it saying, like, going close slowly. When he jumps out, he was like, stops, like, surprised. And then Lucidia says, is it just another false alarm? Saying, sword? With Jacob just stating, sort of? Which Lucidia was confused. And Nobby just flew over there saying, yelling out, it's a child! Which Lucidia and Asta kind of ran over, seeing a weird looking child. Which they didn't know what it was, but when Jacob saw it, he was actually kind of frightened and also angry. He was gonna pull his sword, but then Lucidia just stopped him, saying, "What are you doing? It's a child." But him saying, "It is not just a child; it is a demon child." Which Lucidia remembers what he says. What Jacob said about demons and also other creatures that used to live in that time. and also some legends about how they got stuck in the life, the tree thing, whatever. She states, still, he is just a child, nothing more, nothing less. Which he forgot that she doesn't see them how he sees everyone. She sees them through their actions of how they act and how they would react to situations. So he kind of a bit of frustration. He reluctantly, let go of the sword and leaves it in the sheath. Then she just starts carrying the child, with Jacob saying, "What are you doing?" She's saying, "We are taking him home. He is injured." Stating that, fine, because he knows he can't win an argument with her, and he doesn't want to. Because last time she was angry, he was frightened. He was scared for his life. So, pretty much, when they get home, they see the child, the demon child, waking up with bandages wrapped around. He sees, he looks for his in his surroundings, not knowing where he is. And then, two people, pretty much, he sees a man that's sleeping with his sword. And then he hears the door open, seeing a woman with a child, hiding behind her. And with the demon child saying, who are you people? With pretty much Lucidia introducing her and her family. And also Navi, since Navi decided to stay with them. And the demon child saying, why did you save me? She said, simple, you were just a child. We can leave someone who's young, really young, out there. It's dangerous. Which him stating, but why? She said, should there be a reason? It's the right thing to do. So pretty much he was saying, and then she said, and then Jacob said, saying, what happened and how did you get out? In a really menacing tone. And then Lucidia just slaps him in the back of the head. Him saying, ow, what was that for? Saying, be. And Lucidia just says, be nice. With, the smile with, a menacing, really creepy aura in the background. Him just doing a bit of a sweat. There was, a bit of a sweat happening to him. And he says, okay, dear. And he says, what are you doing? And he just re-says, saying, what are you doing here and what happened? With Li Bei saying his backstory that he got beat up from his kind. And he somehow made it into the surface, the human world. He doesn't know how, but he did. And he doesn't know where to go anywhere. Lucidia, and then Asta says, has an idea, saying, you can be my older brother if you want, nervously. And then the demon child says, I don't think that's a good idea. And then pretty much gets cut off by both Navi and Lucidia, saying, that's a great idea. You can be your son, our adopted son. And then, he says, what, are you sure? And pretty much says, I'm a demon. And she says, yeah, you're not the son, the first thing that surprised me. And she just looks at Jacob, him just looking away from, a bit of embarrassment and also annoyed that she's right. Because remember, Jacob is an elf, a fully blooded elf. And the demon child said, what do you mean? And she just explains that, well, my husband is an elf, which pretty much the demon child says, what? So he is, and then that means that he is, and she says, yeah, pretty much. She says, and then she just said, Navi said, if he's going to stay with you, then he's going to need a name, so what should you call him? What should we name him? And Lucidia says, what about Li Bei? Which the demon child says, "Leave? It sounds pretty nice." And he just gives a bit of a smile. And then Asta just comes up saying, "Does that mean I have a big older brother?" With Libe just saying, "Yep, I'm your older brother now." With Jacob still kind of begrudgingly accepting him, mostly because he's scared of his wife, of how angry, if what happens if she gets angry. But then there was one time where both Libe and Asta saw Jacob like fight with a sword, and then Asta came up to his dad saying, "Can you please like this is by the time he was about, let's say, about 5, where he was asked his dad to learn how to fight with a sword. He just gave him a stick saying, "If you learn how to fight with a sword, you're gonna have to first practice." So he just says, so he shows him a couple of moves that he should practice on his own, like how to use and how to strike and like how to defend with a sword, stuff like that. All the basics. And Asta does this with a lot of difficulty, Libe helping around the house because he can't leave since he looks like a little demon. And then through time, Jacob started accepting him as his son. And Libe was asked by Jacob if he can talk to him, which Libe was saying, okay. He called him, sir. Instead of, like, calling him dad, he calls him sir, because he knows, like, he needs to take his distance, and then pretty much Jacob just says, "Drop the formalities, it's fine, I accept you as my son already," Libe was shocked about, but also happy that his newfound family is fully accepting him with open arms. He's happy with the life he's living right now. And then they just talk, saying that, "There's one thing I haven't told you. I'm not from this." Like, he talks to Libe saying that, "You do know who I am, right? And what type of speech, what I am, right?" And Libe says, "Yeah, you're an elf." And then he just says, "There's something I haven't told even your mother or your younger brother, and I'm trusting you since you're the oldest." With Libe stating, "Okay, what is it?" Saying, "You do know time magic, right?" Which, with Libe stating, "I know there's that type of magic, but what does it involve this?" Saying that, "I'm not from this time. I'm from the past." Which Libe saying, "Wait, what?" Which him confused, saying, "What do you mean?" And Jacob explains for someone like the age of, like, I would say maybe him, he's by the time the age of, let's say, 8, which Libe is, he's like older than Asta, and Asta's like let's say 6 at this time, so he's like 2 years older than Asta. And then Libe asks, "What do you mean?" Jacob says, "I used a forbidden type of magic that shouldn't be used." And Asta, and pretty much Jacob asked, "What forbidden magic was it?" He asked, "Magic that can manipulate what time I can go to, but it comes with a cost." And pretty much Libe asks, "What's the cost?" Time doesn't easily affect me. Like, for example, let's say if you go through time, it doesn't easily affect him. It just mostly, he aged slower than the regular human or like elf, I would say. But he can still be killed by like getting stabbed through the sword, whatever. He can still die in regular terms, but except for aging. So it's like, he says, "So I can't die through regular terms as an aging, but I can die through regular terms of like a wound or any fatal wound or any a fatal sickness, anything like that." So that's the drawback, a bit of a drawback. Libe saying, "That's a bit of a sad drawback." And Libe and Jacob knows, yeah, that is. Then let's say a few, and but then Jacob says, pretty much saying that you cannot tell anyone, not even your own mother or brother, because if they know this, then they would kind of feel sad about it. So Libe kept it a secret. But then one day, when Libe just was getting some water for like so he can wash the clothes with his mom, Asta and Jacob were like out practicing swordsmanship since and also let's say Jacob got him a wooden sword. I got Asta a wooden sword for his as a little present that he for so he they can train a bit more. And then one day something was happening to Libe. He was feeling control. He screamed to where both Jacob and Asta and Lucidia was able to hear. So they all ran towards. Lucidia was able to get there first, of course, saying, "What's wrong?" What? And Navi was there, was as like a overseer, like just able to see what goes on, and just give them like a heads up, like dinner's ready. It pretty much, let's say, they weren't. Both Jacob and Asta weren't able to hear, but Navi told Asta and Jacob that something's wrong with Libe. Something happened. He's screaming. I don't know why. So they both start running as fast as they can to the house. Then when they get there, Libe is like struggling. It's like he's holding half of his face for some reason. Lucidia is there and she doesn't know why. Then when Libe says, "Help me," like struggling, and he's saying, and Asta says, "What's happening, big brother? What's wrong?" Saying, and then Libe saying, "The demon king is trying to control me." When both of the parents pretty much knew what he was talking about, because let's go to a bit of a flashback, saying that there was that he told them that there's a demon king and all the stuff about demon hierarchy and stuff, and he was the lowest demon, pretty much. And then we cut that flashback. Asta doesn't understand since he's really young, but then both Lucidia and Jacob ask him. "You can't control this. You can," like they both try to tell him that he has to take control. But then the demon that's controlling him, or like well, the demon king, is saying, "I'm able to be," like he's finally yelling that he's free. He's soon to be free after trapped at that prison. I can finally be free and like this control this world, stuff like that. For some reason, Asta sees, doesn't just see one, but there's something else behind that creepy smile, that look, it's something that is frightening him. He sees the eyes of someone that's done countless evil. He isn't just alone. He's also there's also someone there with him, but it's dormant. That sleep, it's dormant. It's sleep. It doesn't know what like he doesn't know what it is, but something tells him to like run away. But Asta stays his ground, yelling at Libe that he can do it. My brother is like my big brother is strong. You can take care over of yourself. Pretty much, and also Jacob yells at Libe and, tells Lucidia to get what they needed for this precaution. So Lucidia goes inside the house and grabs something, while Jacob is telling, like holding on to Libe, saying, "You can do it, son. Come on, you. I believe in you. You are strong. You are someone that can overcome this." And also saying, "If things don't go to plan, we have this. Remember what we told you. We have a second. It can protect you." Like he was like scared that bad things would happen to his family, so he said, "Just I don't think I can do it." When he was getting control, and then when Lucidia just came back, she they both try to hold back, like, Libe, but then instantly they both get stabbed. Asta, seeing this, he was in shock and he didn't know what to do. With Libe just screaming out "No!" to his parents, and say, and then when Lucidia says, "It's okay," like she forgives him. "I hope one day that you can protect your younger brother," stuff like that, and she puts him in the grimoire. Him just saying, when I get stronger, I will protect you both and Asta. The last thing he does is look at Asta and says, "I'm sorry." Asta doesn't know what just happened. And everything just went so fast for him. He didn't know what happened. And then the last thing when he did was just says, "No, no." Then he just instantly goes running towards his parents, saying, "Mom, Dad, please, please be okay. Please be okay. Mom, Dad." He was starting to cry. He was gonna cry and yell out everything. But then his dad, Jacob, tells him something. "It's okay. It's okay. You have to be strong. You have to be strong and be careful of what of carrying this book. Your big brother is in here. And if people see this, they may hurt him. Or even worse. So protect your big brother right now. Because right now, he's going through a long sleep." And Asta thought of, "So you're going to sleep, right? And get better, right? Right?" With Jacob just stating, "I'm sorry, Asta. You're going to have to be alone for a while. But someday you will meet people that will help you." Lucidia saying, "Be kind." And then Lucidia says, "My poor baby Asta, please, be kind. Don't be careful. Be kind of people. Just don't hurt anyone. Be kind in how you are. Don't change." With both putting their hands on both Asta's, like, side cheeks, and then just both slowly dying, with Asta saying, "Mom," like he's shaking both his parents. Sorry if you're hearing sound in the background. It's just neighbors, like some neighbors' kids are just screaming. But he shakes both of his parents, just yelling out, just screaming out, saying, "No!" And after that, Asta was silent. He looked empty. It's like he couldn't talk. He was just too numb for everything, anything. So, and then let's just say a few months go, like let's say a few months go by. Asta was still training and stuff because he wants to be strong. He wants to protect others. And then he looks all dirty because he doesn't have money. He doesn't know how to work. He goes to the forest to get food. And yeah. So one day when Asta goes to the village, he sees two kids, one with blonde hair and the other one with black hair. Two kids, one kid crying and the other one, both kids crying, yelling out for help, help, someone please help, with the guy saying, "Shut up, I'm gonna sell these two necklaces and for good money." Asta seeing this was really angry for seeing some adult just pretty much just bullying and beating these kids up. So what he did is he grabbed the wooden sword that his dad gave him and ran towards the guy and knocked him out, hitting him in the chin. Almost like an uppercut, if you can say. And then pretty much knocking out the guy, getting the two bracelets, the two necklaces, and giving it to the two kids that were crying. And he just gave it to them, the kids were really stopping the crying, just grabbed the necklace. He just walks off, nothing more than but a fake smile. He just walks up, says, "Wait, what's your name? And he says, Asta. My name is Asta. And then Zelda says, where are your parents? And that's when Asta's smile was gone and turned into a face of just sadness. And he said, they're gone. With Yuno stating, I'm sorry, but... And he asks, do you want to come to the live with us? Asta confusing, what do you mean? Zelda says, we're both orphans and we live in a church, so we ask if you want to come and live with us in the orphanage. Asta says, sure, why not? I don't have anywhere else to go. But first I need to get some stuff. Is it okay if it's tomorrow? Because I first need to get some stuff. And they said, is it okay? Is it okay if we bring an adult with us? Asta says, yeah, sure, I don't mind. So pretty much we skip a bit to the next day in the morning. Asta getting everything ready in a bag, and also he sneaks in the grimoire in there. But before he leaves, he sees his eyes go to a bandana the one that his dad used to wear to hide his ears. He goes to it and grabs it and puts it on. It's a bit big. It's a bit more big for him. It's a bit big for him, so it kind of goes to as it like slips to his neck, to like a necklace in a way. But he just leaves it like that. And then he goes to the place where they met with Yuno and Zelda being there with Elizabeth. And they both said to explain to Elizabeth that his parents passed away, like they're gone, and Elizabeth feeling sad for the child, saying it's okay, like saying, explaining to him that, would you like to come, let's go, like just saying let's go, come on, let's go to the church. They do walk over there and go to the church. Asta, just feeling sad, just asks, is there any way to take a bath? Because he hasn't taken a bath in a few months or weeks, I would say. And then, pretty much, he does go take a bath and then comes back. Well, and someone was going through his bag. One of the kids were going through his bag. And let's say this kid was, like, rude and a bit of a jerk. Since he, of course, some kids are jerks when they're younger. He goes through, and then he sees a necklace. And he says, wow, pretty necklace. I guess it's mine now. Which Asta says, no, leave it, let go. Give me back my necklace. Which the kid just says, no, it's mine now. Saying, give it back. With Elizabeth coming into the room saying, what's wrong? With the kid that stole the necklace saying, he's trying to steal my necklace and stuff like that. With Asta saying, no, it's my necklace. She stole it from my bag. And then Elizabeth says, okay, so if, okay, then where, how did you get, she asked a simple question. She took the necklace and she says, okay. If it's really yours, how did you get it? He said, nervously, he says, I found it in the, he kept stuttering, saying, I found it in the forest, like, made up a story. And then she looked at Asta, saying, and how did you get in it? How, if it's yours, a necklace, how did you get it? Saying, like, he just sat looking down, saying, it's from my mother, from my mom, the last thing I remember before she was gone. Her hearing this, saying, Just giving it to her, and then the kid saying, "Why are you giving him my necklace?" With Elizabeth saying, "It is not your necklace. You took it from him, and this is the last memory he has from his mother. So please respect him, respect, and don't steal what's not yours." And also, let's say Asta and Yuno started becoming like brothers in a way. Asta was always silent, the silent type, and also Zelda also wanted to be friends with him, so they were like brothers and sisters in a way. He doesn't fully have like his old emotions, like his goofy smile and stuff. He does have those some time to time when he plays around with the younger kids in the church with us. But he's mostly silent outside from like meeting new people and stuff like that. So yeah, right now that's what we're gonna leave it to, and I hope you guys have a great day, and thank you so much for the support for the last video, and I hope you guys enjoy. Have a great day. See ya.